Rockies.
Welcome back to Castle Coliseum. 53-45 is the final score. Yeah, we're talking about a win, but we've also got our eyes on a couple of little ones underneath the hoop, so we'll make sure they're okay.
All right, okay.
Let's talk about the win. Virginia Tech comes up with an 8-point victory today against the Clemson Tigers. I could put a lot of words on it. I don't know if it's gritty or ugly or grind it out, or which one did you want to go with today?
Check.
Yep.
You know, as long as they go in the right column, you know, we'll take it. Yep. You know, because I told the kids, we played some games this year where we've been pretty and we lost. And, but they found a way, and this is going to really build character for us. We didn't play great basketball, you know, but things aren't going to always be smooth for us right now. We're playing people out of position, and you know, kids are, you know, they're getting tired and whatnot. And also, Clemson plays a style that they really minimize the possession. So everyone needs a little bit more. They're going to walk the ball off the floor. And, so we didn't have it, especially early. We didn't have it at all. We looked a little dead, looked a little tired. But the grit, you know, throughout the game, and I praise them for the fact that the looks on their faces, they continue to fight. Rachel Camp did not play a perfect game, but she had a perfect attitude. And she came out, and because she had the perfect attitude, you know, she made some huge plays for us at the end. I thought she was magnificent. And I just really appreciate everything that she did, because I love her. I love her. I love her effort and what she did for us. It was tremendous. I thought Reagan McGarity's defense on Thornton was unbelievable. That kid's a talented kid. You know, she shoots the ball in a way that there's not a whole lot you can do. And Reagan, you know, bothered her a lot, you know, a lot on her jump shots, and did a really good job. You know, I don't think I took Reagan out again. Did we get 40 minutes again?
Well, let's see.
I think we did.
Yep, right there. For the second time in her career, 40 minutes.
You know, and it's, and then we came out, and I thought Taylor did a good job, you know, getting us some offense going as of late. So, you know, Kendall stepped up, had 6 rebounds, which probably is a career high, but Taylor had, you know, 10. And they had to all step up and do a little bit more than what they're accustomed to.
Right, there was one specific moment in this game. How about the three-pointer for Rachel Camp with about 2 minutes to go? Not only does Rachel knock it down, but the growth point. Sometimes this team has tunnel vision, and Emery is able to see the open shooter despite the fact that she's covered and kicks it. That's a small growth point that you can look at.
Well, it's a growth point that we've been focusing on. We've been watching film. We've been teaching. We've been talking about it. And so now that they're able to see it in a different manner. So it was really good. It was a really good play. I was very happy, you know, for all of them to not only for it to be executed, but they understood, you know, what they needed to do. So it was a big play, and I was happy that Rachel was able to knock it down, because, man, she just went out and played. She had amnesia, you know, even when things weren't great, she had amnesia, and she just kept playing hard, and she made some really good plays for us, and, you know, I just want to go give her a big hug. She came over to me and was trying to apologize, you know, for some of the mistakes that she made, and I'm like, what? No way, don't you apologize, you're playing your heart out. So, you know, I'm really, really happy for her, and just appreciative of her efforts tonight. So it's a tough team to play. They're athletic, they're strappy, they're long, they're very long, and they present some problems for you. And, I thought we really won this game on the defensive end.
Right, how about this for one of these generic media type vague questions, but you do come up with 6 ACC wins and continue to hold on to that 9th spot in the ACC standings, which is buying the tournament 6 wins in the ACC ties a program mark. For you, as you kind of step back, if you can, what do these little things mean for you at the moment?
Progress, you know, and that it is a process. You know, we all want to jump into a situation, a situation where, you know, you're going to win a lot of basketball games, but that happens to very few. You know, I knew coming here that it was going to be a process. And, you know, if you go from 4 wins, 4 ACC wins the first year to 6, and counting in the second, you know, I think that you're trending in the right direction, because this league is too good. You don't just walk into this league and add water and you're going to be at the top of the league. You have to come in and you have to build it. You have to build it the right way. You have to learn it. You know, I've learned more this year, more than I knew last year. You know, and I'm sure that next year I'll be even more ready for the situation, and knowing my team and knowing the other teams in the league. And I think the biggest thing that people don't talk about is that, yeah, everyone knows that there's a lot of good teams in this league, but to have to prepare for them, you know, night in and night out. You know, it's like, you know, we just had a gut-wrenching performance, you know, against UVA, and we had to go to Wake. You know, you come home, you got Clemson, and you got to go to Notre Dame, and then you follow it up with a trip to Miami. You know, and so it's just, it's tough, but the kids are really fighting through, and, you know, our situation is we don't have as many players that we would like. We want to be deep, You want to be deep. You have to be deep anywhere. You want to be deep, you know, in the post, because that's where all the banging goes on. And but the kids are really, you know, persevered through, you know, a lot of the adversity and done a really good job.
I will get you out of here on this. It was the play for K game, which is always nice. Plus, I know it wasn't a huge senior day, but some important pieces that we certainly like to work on.
Well, you know, it's more than just the pink shoes. It's more than just the pink outfits or the pink uniforms. You know, the real cause for this is to make sure we bring awareness to this nasty kind of disease. And, you know, I love the fact that we are bringing awareness to it, but I always want to make sure that the kids and anybody that we talk to know why we're doing it. You know, not just a trend, not just, you know, a fashion statement. It's a nasty disease that I'm sure if you sit there and you think about it, it's touched each and every one of us in some way, shape, or form. And hopefully, you know, any awareness that we can bring as a program or as women's basketball will help the fight, because I really do. You know, I hope and pray that there's a cure in my lifetime. And the only way that it happens is you have, you know, the resources to go out and have the research. And you know, one of the best things I thought for me was that our kids, you know, came in and they were talking about taking, you know, some of the money that they have and donating. You know, and those are the things that we like to do and get them to be aware. You know, we want to wear the pink uniforms and stuff, but we want to make sure we utilize the opportunity in the right way. You know, I think these kids really understand it. So it means a lot to me, and, you know, I never knew Coach Yao. But one of my assistants, Krista Kilburn-Sebeski, who's the head coach at Hofstra now, played for Coach Yao. And I heard a lot about her fight, and just the kind of person that she was. And so I felt a little bit connected to the situation, you know, just because of 6 degrees of separation, you know, but it's something that, you know, is near and dear to me, and I always want to try to bring awareness to the situation.
And the tip of the cap, please.
You know what, you know, people may be looking at it and saying, we only have one senior on the roster, and that's DeAndre DeRosa, and she didn't play this year. You know, she had the opportunity to come back, and, you know, she's trying to get healthy. She's had a magnitude of an injury since she's been here, and so, you know, we just wanted to make sure that, you know, she's getting the best out of her career. You know, we probably could have thrown her in the last part of the season, but, you know, it would have really been a situation where she didn't get to utilize and have the best career. So we gave her the option, and she decided that she would rather wait the situation. But our managers, you know, Alexis, and we call her Beyonce Bria, they're tremendous. People don't understand what they have to do and the way they have to do their job and do it tirelessly. It's a thankless job. You know, it's a job that not a lot of people would really want. And that's not glamorous, but they get to do a lot here on the program. And I tell you what, these are the kind of kids that you want to hire. These are the kind of kids that you want to hire, because no job is too big, no job is too small for them. And they do it with a smile on their face, with a great attitude. And those are the kind of young people that are going to work their way up very, very quickly. As a matter of fact, my predecessor at JMU, he was a manager. You know, he was a manager on my team. And I hired him as an assistant coach because of his work ethic as a manager. I knew that there was nothing that was, you know, beneath him, and he would do anything. And he was like that as an assistant coach. You know, if I asked him to drive to Alaska, okay, he would try to find a way. You know, if I asked him to drive to Hawaii, he would try to find a way. And those two young ladies are in that same mold. They do a tremendous job. And then Sammy Goldsmith, I love her. She's my heart. She does a great job for us. I think she reminds me a lot of me in a lot of different ways. I love the bringing her in on the Chalk Talks. I love having her around, and I think that she's going to be a very special kid. I call her a kid. She's blossoming into a wonderful young lady. But just having her around, my staff, our support staff, you know, Andrew, they are tremendous. You're only as good as the people around you, and I have some great people around me who they came to Hokie Nation. Hokie Nation, you know, adopted them and, you know, just welcomed them with open arms, and, you know, they're every bit a part of this organization, this program, this school, and they love it. And it's been a blessing for me in the first 2 years. I couldn't be this far ahead if it weren't for these people around me.
Coach, congrats. Hokies get the win today over the Clemson Tigers.